Hi everyone, I am Beatrice. In this video, we will look at signs of pregnancy. Now, when assessing a client for pregnancy, nurses must distinguish between signs that suggest pregnancy from signs that are highly likely, from signs that actually confirm pregnancy. Now, for the purpose of your exams, we classify them into three. They are presumptive, probable, and positive signs. We will look at each of these signs one after the other, and before the end of this video, we'll look at some NCLEX-style questions that will test your knowledge on this topic. So if you are ready for today's video, let's begin. First, let's look at presumptive signs. So presumptive signs, as it is, we are just presuming. So these signs are subjective to the woman. It's actually the signs the woman feels. And these signs are not proof, they are just suggestive of pregnancy. The first one is amenorrhea. That's missed period. That's a sign that maybe this woman could be pregnant. Another sign is breast changes. So for breast changes, the breast can feel tender, can feel enlarged. At times, the areola can feel darkened. So the woman will feel so sensitive on around the breast, and little thing, the woman could feel some pain. So that's a sign that could suggest pregnancy. The next one is morning sickness. The usual nausea, vomiting. Most times when you see a woman throwing up early in the morning, people begin to imagine or think, is this woman pregnant? So that is a sign again that is presumptive. Then another one is fatigue. So this fatigue has to do with tiredness. Unusual tiredness. You wake up, it's as if you didn't really sleep at night. So you just feel so tired. It's as if you never had a good sleep. At times you don't even want to do anything. You don't want to stand up from the bed. You feel so exhausted. Then another one is urinary frequency. So increased urination. This could be another sign. Then we have quickening. So quickening has to do with that first fetal movement. So the woman can say, I feel some movement around my abdomen. I feel that something is moving inside of me. Now, these are all suggestive. They are not proof of pregnancy. And this quickening can happen between week 16 to 20 gestation. So between that period, the woman could experience it. They are all signs that are presumptive. They are not actual proof that the woman is pregnant. The next one is probable signs. So as it is probable, so like under probability. So these ones are objective. They are more like what the examiner observed. So it's not just what the woman says, I feel, or how I feel, but it's about what the examiner is able to observe. So it's more objective. And this one is more likely to suggest pregnancy, but it's still not a proof that a woman is pregnant. So one of them includes the positive pregnancy test. So when a woman tests positive for pregnancy, is a probable sign, it's still not a confirmation. Because other things can also make a woman test positive. Let's say there's a tumor growing there, or a woman is on some drugs, it can lead to false positive. So don't confuse it that positive pregnancy sign is a positive sign of pregnancy. Don't confuse it. We are saying positive pregnancy test. So it's not a confirmation that a woman is pregnant. Now, the next one is enlarged uterus or abdominal growth. So for this one, when you see a woman, abdomen looks enlarged or look bigger than the usual. So it could be a probable sign. You just begin to think that this woman is pregnant. But remember that growth can mimic that. So let's say a woman has fibroid or any tumor, it can make the abdomen look bigger. So it's not the confirmation that a woman is pregnant. The next one is ballotment. So ballotment means the fetus rebounds when either the cervix or the uterus is tapped. Another one is Chadwick sign, Goodell sign, and Hager sign. Now, I want you to note, for these three signs, at times they come out in exam because students can easily mistake the meaning for each. So I will give you a trick that will help you remember. But first of all, the meaning of Chadwick sign has to do with bluish discoloration of the vulva, of the vagina, and even the cervix. So this happened around week 4 of gestation. Now we have Goodell sign. So Goodell sign has to do with the softening of the cervix. Then this one happened between week 6 to 8 of gestation. And then we have Hager sign. This can happen between week 6 to week 12. So for Hager sign, it has to do with the softening of the uterine setting. So to help you remember, first of all, look at the first letter C, G, and H. So it comes in order, in alphabetical order. So you know that C comes before G and G comes before H. And how do we apply this? So the first thing for Chadwick sign, we're talking about bluish discoloration. So the first thing is that if a woman conceives, when the examiner observes, you see that the vulva, the vagina, and the cervix can get discolored. There could be some changes because of hormonal changes. So that fluid discoloration of the cervix, the vagina, and the vulva is childbirth sign. Now, after that, the next thing is that the cervix itself will become softened. So softening of the cervix is Goodell sign. And then finally, it goes beyond just the cervix. It moves to the uterine segment, the lower uterine segment. If that one gets softened, it's Hagar sign. So it's in progression. So that you can remember with that. Another one is palpation of fetal outline. So when the examiner decides to palpate the woman, tells the woman lie down on your back and do some palpation, they could actually feel the fetal outline. But still, it's not confirmation because it could still be growth. And the last one is Braxton-Hicks contraction. So Braxton-Hicks contraction has to do with forced contraction, contraction that does not lead to cervical dilatation. And then we have positive signs. So as it is, it's positive, it's confirmatory that yes, there is a baby there growing. This woman is actually pregnant. Like I said, don't confuse positive signs with positive pregnancy tests. For positive pregnancy tests, it's under probable sign of pregnancy. So that's the one that has to do with testing to detect the HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin. So this one, either in urine or blood, they can detect it. It's just a test. But when we say positive signs, we are saying things that confirm that this woman is indeed pregnant. The first one is fetal heart detected. If the woman goes for a scan, let's say Doppler scan, or the woman goes and the midwife or the nurse or whoever is examining the woman put a fetoscope on the woman's abdomen and listen and could actually hear a heartbeat. Now, that means indeed a baby is there. The Doppler can even detect this fetal heart sound earlier as 10 weeks. But for fetoscope, it could get even up to 20 weeks gestation before the fetal heart could actually be detected. The next one is fetal movement. This one is also felt by the examiner. So when they palpate the woman, they could see the fetus moving. So it's obvious this is a sign that this woman is pregnant. And lastly, visualization of the fetus on ultrasound scan. So the last one has to do with now doing an ultrasound to, you know, to scan to see the baby. And then when they do that ultrasound, they see a baby growing there. That's a full confirmation that this woman is pregnant. Now let's look at some NCLEX-style questions that will test your knowledge on signs of pregnancy. Question 1. A client reports breast tenderness, nausea in the morning, and frequent urination. Which type of pregnancy signs are these? A. Probable. B. Presumptive. C. Positive. D. Diagnostic. The best answer is B. Presumptive. So these are symptoms that are subjective. These are symptoms reported by the woman. Question 2. A provider palpates fetal movement during a prenatal visit. This finding is considered A. Presumptive, B. Probable, C. Positive, D. Possible. The best answer is positive. That's a direct confirmation that a fetus is actually there. Question 3. Which of the following is considered a probable sign of pregnancy? A. Nausea, B. Amenorrhea, C. Positive pregnancy test, D. Quickening. The best answer is positive pregnancy test. This is objective. You have to do the test to see that it's positive. But note, it's not a confirmation that the woman is actually pregnant. So this falls under probable sign of pregnancy. Question 4. The softening of the cervix observed during a pelvic exam is called A. Chadwick sign, B. Goodell sign, C. Hagar sign, and D. McDonald sign. The best answer is B. Goodell sign. That's the softening of the cervix. The last question. The bluish purple discoloration of the cervix and vaginal mucosa is known as A. Goodell sign, B. Chadwick sign, C. Hagar sign, and D. Quickening. The best answer is B. Chadwick sign. So that wraps up today's topic on signs of pregnancy. If you find this video useful, please like, share, leave your comment, and subscribe for more educational videos. Thanks for watching.